Hello, my name is Ashley Martineau, and you are watching How to Spin Yarn. This is a video I'm making for beginners to learn the three basic drafting techniques. I'm using a Spinalution Queen Bee spinning wheel, and the fibers I'll be using for this tutorial are an Art Bat by Bricolage Studios, some raw merino wool that I got from my local sheep and wool festival, a cotton puni by Buchanan Fibers, some cotton sliver by Buchanan Fibers, and that's all. So let's get started. I'm starting with an art bat. I've just torn a little bit of it off, and the first drafting technique we're going to be covering is called short forward. So you can take the hand that you prefer, that's your dominant spinning hand or your drafting hand, and as you treadle, you pull fiber 1 inch or 2 inches at a time forward toward the orifice. This is called short forward. Many beginners learn how to spin this way, and I actually prefer to spin this way as well. This is my habit of spinning, is short forward. I spin all my fibers this way. But it's nice to learn all three different types of drafting because different fibers work better with different drafting techniques. And if you're designing a specific type of yarn or a yarn that you want to have like fluffy characteristics or a yarn for warping your loom, you may want to research what drafting technique would make that yarn best for you. So that is short forward with an art bat. Now I'll show you short forward with raw merino locks. It's the same hand motion. And I'm just taking a little bit of fiber at a time. And you'll notice this hand is staying pretty much in the same position, and the movement I'm doing is literally short forward with my right hand. So now I'll show you with a cotton rolag. So we'll start from the edge of the rolag and do short forward with this as well. And you'll notice I'm not changing the ratio as I go from fiber to fiber. I've learned that I don't really need a high ratio to spin cotton as long as I get enough twist in it because I like to treadle quickly. And I can make sure that this cotton does have enough twist in it by pausing and looping it on itself. And if it plies into a nice, tidy yarn, then I have enough twist for it. And the last fiber type that we'll do short forward with is cotton sliver. This type of fiber has a wrong way and a right way. So I'm going to hope that I start the right way, and if not, I'll let you know how it feels and we'll switch it around. So if you're spinning cotton sliver the wrong way, it will be very grabby and yanky, and it will feel like you're having to, there's a lot of friction. So try turning it the opposite direction. So I'm pretty sure I started from the wrong way. Yeah, and that's much smoother. So smooth, in fact, that it just came out of my hand. So that tells me that I need less tension. I tend to work with a lot of tension when I'm spinning. And I'm also going to up the ratio on my wheel by changing the whirl speed back here. I was on the largest speed and now I'm on the middle one. And I can do itty bitty, short forward. Since most beginners learn this way, this is a great way to practice spinning cotton. Many of the other tutorials that I've seen on YouTube use a different drafting technique, which we'll cover, but as long as your yarn stays together, I'm getting a lot of twist in there. See that over twisted section? I'm going to bump up the tension just a little bit and also tread a little slower. I'm used to treadling fast. Okay, so that is short forward, and cotton sliver is pretty difficult. It's probably one of the most difficult fibers that I've found to spin personally. It's definitely doable. It's just a little bit more challenging. It's easy to over twist it, as you can see. So the next fiber spinning drafting technique we're going to do is short backwards. I need to bump my tension up again because I'm back to wool. Okay, so I pull the fiber back and then bring my hand back. Now, the third drafting technique that we'll be learning is long draw. And since my camera is set up here for you to see my hands, I'm not going to be able to go as long as other tutorials on YouTube may go. So definitely look up on YouTube long draw drafting to see all the opportunities you have for this. But my long draw, in order to stay in the frame, is going to be medium draw, I guess. So, you pinch, let the fiber, I need a lot less tension here. So we'll reduce our tension. I'm going to pinch to let the twist gather up, let it go, and then pull my fiber back. Twist, let it go. It's difficult to do this with this art bat. You really need a specific fiber type or preparation. You need something that basically drafts itself. So I'm gonna switch to a different fiber. I'm curious to see if these locks, if I fluff these raw, greasy merino locks up, if they'll be easy to long draw.